Konteks pada episod kali ini kita membawa Dr. Aznul yang merupakan pengarah daripada TTO Office, Technology Transfer Office di UN. Manakala untuk Dr. Amir, beliau merupakan salah seorang orang penting lah di dalam pusat yang bertanggungjawab untuk membawa industri untuk berkolaborasi, untuk bekerjasama dengan penyelidik-penyelidik di universiti. So di sini kita boleh lihat kerjasama di antara industri dan juga penyelidik daripada universiti supaya manfaat yang boleh digunakan oleh rakyat melalui inovasi penyelidikan yang telah
dilaporkan.
Yang telah dilaporkan oleh kerajaan ke universiti supaya dapat dinikmati oleh rakyat di Malaysia. So kita rasa begitu bertuah pada hari ini, dimana kita ada dua view daripada peringkat universiti, dan yang paling penting Dr. Aznul dan juga Dr. Amir, mereka juga terlibat dalam industri dan sebagainya. So sekarang kita beralih kepada pusingan pertama, iaitu memahami peranan universiti di dalam pengkomersialan. So kita boleh straight to the questions lah. So pertamanya, sebab kita tanya Dr. Aznul dulu. Mungkin ada orang di luar sana, dia tertanya-tanya benda TTO ni, technology transfer ni dekat universiti ni. So boleh tak Dr. Aznul boleh terangkan apakah itu technology transfer office?
Okay, so terima kasih Dr. Aznul atas soalan yang sangat dalam cabar ya. Soalan yang logik lah ya. Jadi tech transfer office ni, okay, kalau kita ikut sejarah lah dekat Universiti Melaya, UNCIE itu sendiri telah tertubuh selama lebih daripada 25 tahun. So this is going to be our 26 years. So lepas tu kalau kita tengok daripada segi evolusi in this industri pendidikan tinggi, institut pengajian tinggi di Malaysia ni, we have actually went through several rounds of orang kata perkembangan lah. At first, we were like starting as just a teaching university. So kita punya tugas adalah melahirkan graduan dan yang ready untuk pasaran. And then I think like around 10 years back, kalau dekat Senaya tu, kita marked by then Vice Chancellor Prof. Gao Sejasmo. So we shifted into research university. So dekat Malaysia ni kita ada 5 RU lah, 5 RU, DM one of it, University Senaya. So transition from teaching into research. So kalau kita tengok sekarang sekitar 2013-2012, that was the point yang kita start dengan research ni. So now tak cukup dengan research macam yang Dr. Af cakap tadi tu, pelaburan daripada kerajaan dan juga orang kata kita lah as taxpayer, how do we shift into commercializing the research output tu? Okay, so that's the bigger role of tech transfer lah. Okay, so walaupun UM telah orang kata bergiat dalam hak intelek ni selama 25 tahun, tapi dia follow the phase yang macam kita cakap tadi. During teaching and research era tu, dia lebih berkait kepada awareness. Nak make sure researcher, ahli akademik, staff akademik di universiti ni ada awareness berkenaan dengan kepentingan untuk melindungi hasil penyelidikan mereka. Okay. Tapi at that time, you know, perlindungan ataupun IP ni dilakukan sebab kita shift daripada research kepada commercialization tu, dia punya perubahan tu tak disertai dengan KPI lah, senang cerita, for the lack of better words, benda yang orang tak suka sangat sebut. Tapi meaning to say that kalau file for IP tu lebih kepada satu garisan dalam CV
ataupun daripada requirement untuk grant.
Requirement untuk naik pangkat dan sebagainya. So sekarang tugas saya, tugas Dr. Amir ni dah makin berat. Sebab kita bukan lagi setakat nak menggalakkan orang untuk protect their IP, but mereka protect their technology and their research output. But we are in this process of ensuring that they have this spirit to not only protect their research, but they have a proper plan macam mana dia nak commercialize, macam mana nak kerjasama dengan industry. So itu cabaran kami sekarang ni, yang kata sangat berat lah. Sebab before this, it was more just filing, and masa tu pun kita ada dana yang banyak untuk kita file for IP dan protect. Sekarang ni kita bekerja dengan dana yang sedikit dan kita nak make sure kita boleh transition. So ada banyak cabaran pada ini, tapi itulah, kita Malaysia ni, kita Malaysia boleh. So kita boleh buat.
Kita yakin kita boleh.
Yes. Okay. Itu sedikit lah.
Okay. A bit of of that context kan. Sebab Dr. Azrul ada bagi tahu berkaitan dengan cabaran dan sebagainya. Boleh tak Dr. Azrul share pada kami apakah cabaran yang orang kata boleh, orang kata manageable yang mungkin universiti ataupun UM plan untuk
menyelesaikan. Okay, so saya ni seorang yang sangat pragmatik lah sebenarnya. Saya, sebab universiti, kita memang kena menyokong orang kata hala tuju universiti. Macam recently, even dalam amanat tahun baru Naik Chancellor Universiti Melayu, Datuk Seri Dr. Nor Azwan, memang dia sangat jelas antara benda yang dia cuba dukung adalah kerjasama dengan industri. Dia nak push.
Okay.
Dan juga for apa globalization of the university. Kan? Tapi bila kita lihat dengan lebih dekat budaya penyelidikan sendiri dekat universiti tu, dia tak transcend towards commercialization. Sebab kalau macam kita tengok dalam publication, kita ambil tahu orang kata apa yang dilakukan oleh rakan-rakan kita, and we invite them as our OPI, as our apa co-author. Tapi suddenly when it comes to intellectual property, semua nak jadi jago, semua nak jadi hero, semua nak go alone lah. Maksudnya dia ada produk dan dia pula, dia yang research, dia nak commercialize, dia nak approach industry. It's a one man show. It's satu culture yang
that's interesting.
Ha, kan? Tapi kalau kita tengok dengan lebih besar, culture tu datang dari mana? Culture tu sebenarnya datang daripada macam Silicon Valley, Bill Gates. Sebab tapi sebenarnya Bill Gates ataupun nama-nama besar macam Mark Zuckerberg ni, even tu dia dinaikkan sebagai satu individu, tapi ada tim yang banyak ni belakang ni. Kita tak nampak tu. Tapi itulah yang mereka cuba sebar luaskan kepada dunia, that this is satu figura yang orang kata yang boleh apa.
Secara tak langsung menunjukkan persepsi. Yeah. So, single person can change the world.
Kalau saya boleh komen sikit lagi. So, saya suka bawa satu case tadi lah. Kalau macam saya pernah terbaca BYD. BYD yang orang kata tak mana-mana datang, tiba-tiba they were able to take over Tesla.
Yes.
Tapi bila kita study BYD at that point yang saya baca artikel tu, mereka ada 16,000 patent. Okay. So just imagine a single company have 16,000 patents with a single vision of being the number one electric vehicle company.
Yep.
So kalau kita ambil case study itu dengan kita tengok fungsi universiti, universiti ni kita buat research yang pelbagai.
Betul.
So collaboration dekat research ada, tapi untuk commercialization kurang, tak berfokus. Jadi itulah yang saya nampak, yang saya cuba push lah at this moment. Yang bila IP wise tu, it should also go in a team. Kalau jabatan tu dia file for IP, ahli jabatan yang lain kena ambil tahu so that dia boleh menyokong. So dia macam a big puzzle that people put together untuk create satu produk yang lengkap lah. Mungkin tak lengkap pun tak apa, janji boleh support kan. Tapi that's the spirit lah yang saya rasa yang kami dekat UMSIT ni, Isnaya akan cuba push.
Okay. Kita akan bincang berkaitan dengan IP kemudian dengan lebih detail. So kita beralih kepada Dr. Amir. So saya percaya kita tadi dengar daripada Dr. Azrul berkaitan dengan peranan dan kerjasama industri. So daripada pihak Dr. Amir, mungkin boleh share sedikit pada semua berkaitan dengan peranan industri dekat universiti dan kenapa kita tak dapat lagi lihat industri dekat Malaysia ni boleh bekerjasama dengan universiti dengan lebih baik.
Silakan. Okay. So to start with, industri dengan akademia is two different world lah.
Okay.
So they all usually talk with different languages, then they have different intentions, and each parties ni want to profit themselves lah. Industri nak menguntungkan industri, universiti nak menguntungkan industri.
Masa-masa agenda.
Ya, masa-masa agenda. So our function basically to bridge these two worlds lah. I find it very interesting. I mean, I will complete my third years sebagai deputy director at the center hujung bulan ni. I mean, yalah hujung bulan ni.
Sambung
kontak.
Will be end in 2027.
Lama lagi lah kita akan berdebat.
Anyway, so first kita kena aware dan akui benda tu.
Betul.
Okay. The industry want to make profit. Universiti pun
embrace it.
Yes, exactly. So kalau kita embrace, dia tidak jadi macam kita, okay, universiti nak mampu guna industri atau industri nak mampu gunakan universiti. Because we are leveraging on each other. Maknanya, kalau for lack of better word, kita mempergunakan each other lah. But actually we apa ni, and it's good. It's good. Kalau kata you can embrace it and you can kata apa, akui benda tu dan boleh manage it well, then dia akan jadi a collaboration lah.
Nama pun kerjasama kan?
Yes,
kita kerjasama seseorang sebab kita perlukan something orang tu. Sama juga dengan orang tu, kadang kerjasama tidak establish anything.
Yes. And again, apa echo apa yang Dr. Azrul sebut tadi tu, we cannot do it alone. We cannot maknanya akademik nak pergi buat the research and then nak pergi commercialiskan dia. One man show ke ataupun just one team from academic ni nak buat all things, cannot. Apatah lagi kalau one man lah. And I believe benda ni it goes back to so macam kalau kita tengok why it's happening sekarang ni, maknanya kita macam masih a little bit slow lah, as I would say, on this commercialization punya route ni, because we are not incentivized to do that.
Yes, agree. Can't agree more on that.
Yeah. Contohnya kalau kata kita back to our KPI, every year we have the publication KPI.
Yep.
But if you push one technology, katalah you buat basic research and then you go along the TRL level tu, how many publication would you get?
Yes.
And just maybe one or two je. A few lah. Not like 20 publication, 30 publications. Nak yang to supply your yearly KPI tu.
Okay.
But you have to push and it's hard work. How many KPIs do we get kalau kata we engage dengan industri, kita kata successfully make a collaboration, how many did we get? And it cannot compensate the papers that we publish. So usually researcher, we go back. Katalah macam kalau saya, saya buat analogi macam apa, there's two kind of research. Either you go upwards or downwards. Nothing wrong with doing apa, going downwards. Downwards tu maksudnya you go more fundamental. So meaning that if you decide to do basic research and you go downwards, you're gonna win like Nobel Prize or something.
Okay, fundamental
so research. You go towards more fundamental. If you go upwards, you will go
applied
and towards the pushing your research to the TRL of your research. So you decide. You can go downwards and go upwards. Now, I believe as a kata apa, a nation punya direction, we want our research to go upwards. But upwards path ni will not result you a massive amount of publication.
Okay, correct. So completely agree on that, on the how we want to balance lah. So the following up questions regarding the collaborations with the industry and whatnot, apakah cabaran daripada Senex ni, daripada pengalaman Prof berkaitan dengan nak menjemput industri supaya this kind of, this about mindset sebenarnya dan pemahaman.
Mindset, yes.
So bagaimana nak buat cabaran dia?
Okay, so cabarannya adalah we usually take things macam apa, one or zero. Macam contohnya, okay, it is either mine or yours or something like that. Maknanya you have to spell it very clearly and so on. But in the world that we engage in, they are in between one and zero.
Yes. Fuzzy.
Fuzzy. Yeah. You cannot state all as one and zero.
Correct.
Okay. So that's why our approach adalah first we have to manage, we have to make a friendship contohnya. Okay, friendship is not one and zero.
Yes, of course. Kadang-kadang hari ini tajak minum, esok kita
And developing trust.
Yep.
You cannot just developing trust to on paper.
Correct. Or in a meeting.
So that is the things yang necessary dan missing. Kalau kata we want to engage with one parties from academia and another party from industry, we just do go it officially.
Yes.
Macam okay ni, and then what is perjanjian macam mana and so on. Apa? So very official and very itu, yang itu akan menyebabkan kita cannot apa ni collaborate well with each other.
Yeah.
So in some way kita kena develop friendship, develop trust and take some risk. This one is like these two parties ni kena take some risk.
Yeah,
contohnya betul. Kalau kata universiti terlalu safeguard their own apa ni IPs, so dia akan jadi macam industri pun okay. You, yes. Maybe you don't want, then because industri pun ada things yang dia tak kena safeguard.
Okay,
betul. they cannot hold being held ransom for the things that they yang katakanlah dia sponsor research and so on. And at the end of the day, dia kena bayar pula royalty for that research.
Yeah.
Yeah, I sponsored this research.
Ah, sudah.
That's it. So, yang itu yang kita kena manage lah.
Yeah.
And if manage well, sebenarnya dua-dua ni boleh, boleh thrive in the very challenging world lah. Sebenarnya, our challenge is not this. Our challenge is what problem we need to tackle.
Correct.
Yes. Contoh kata macam food security, we need to tackle the challenge of food security.
Betul.
Not the kata apa. Which parties yang dapat apa and so on.
Dia punya main goal dah.
Main goal tu. Or AI or whatever. Yeah, I believe macam AI tu is like the near future biggest marketplace lah.
Correct. So just a bit of kata question, additional bonus lah. Bonus question lah. So when you talk about collaboration of industry dengan universiti, numbers will be something yang very sexy lah to the top management in the universities. For your experience, how many collaboration that you deem successful in a year, for example?
In a year for a particular academic or the point?
Particular projects yang berjaya di-establishkan antara universiti dan juga industri.
In our center?
Yes.
In our center, I would say there are more than 100 projects that we are involved in.
Wow, okay.
Of course, various kind of assistance that we play.
Mm-hmm.
Ada yang project that we get it for our academics. Ada yang project that academics get the project and we depends. Help manage. All in all, I can say more than 100 project.
That would be fantastic, man. So yeah, that will be great. So now let's moving up to the next round, which is on the part of collaboration and partnership, because we have a bit a touch of that. Okay, so that I refer back to Dr. Amir lah, regarding how the things that you do in you doing right now in the SENET. So what is the practice that you do? Macam mana cara you attract this industry to come to UTM?
Okay, usually it will be when industry will attracted by our names lah,
yes, like
UM or UPM. they want to approach the university. If they want to approach the university, probably the first name that come into their mind is UM, definitely. For example. Yeah, definitely. And
top university what?
And second would be lah either UTM or UKM or UPM or some premier or research university. And when they approach, they bring some kind of pain point or their own real problem.
Mm.
So the thing that there is one case lah. There's one case. There's one company. They said they want to explain their pain points or explain their problems.
Mm-hmm.
So our TTO office blast the email.
Okay.
And only one academic attended.
Okay,
alright. I attended that session.
So you're the one
there? Yeah, I'm okay. I was surprised. Oh, only one. Only me. Yeah. And it was online, okay. But yeah, only one. And the company said they have went to several university and no apa, tak ada orang yang sambut.
Okay.
I mean, tak ada orang. Because,
back to suspicion.
Yeah. Because every academic would like to say that, oh, this is my territory and that is not my territory. So to facilitate that, kita, macam our center ni have to macam give some courage to academics. Mm-hmm. Although this is not a tertiary, I think you are the nearest.
That
can facilitate, that can help this country. You probably the nearest that can help. So because the thing is, the problem that the industry bring in is real problem.
Betul?
And we seldom see this real problem sebenarnya.
Yes.
Academics we are used to a manufactured problem.
Synthetic problem.
Yeah, synthetic problem. Because we have a solution, and then we produce the problem and we solve the problem.
Yep.
That is like our kata apa benda yang kita dah biasa buat.
Kadang-kadang dekat industri dia bawa problem tu is not kata bombastic pun benda.
Not bombastic.
Don't have to our research yang buat dengan 2-3 PhD pun sebenarnya is
exactly
fundamental.
Yeah. Exactly, not so rocket science.
Yes.
It's just apa ni, and I help the company towards solving their problem too with a survey that I know. I mean, I do some literature review. Okay, I get the survey, I do the project.
Mm-hmm.
So and the company like it so much.
You know.
I was surprised.
Padahal benda tu kita buat hari-hari kan, kita macam like our day in day out job lah.
Betul. Another example adalah regarding with my project, we did a mercury detector for quite a long time.
Okay.
To us, to detect mercury is like it's not so difficult, and we would feel that we want to detect other. It's kind of boring to detect mercury. We want to detect other metals.
Mm,
okay. Uh-huh. But I was shocked when I learned that actually Petronas is looking for mercury detection.
Yeah.
And they want to detect mercury but not other metals.
Okay.
So it's sometimes it's things that we easy for us to do,
mm-hmm.
and difficult for other parties to do.
Mm.
So probably we are looking for more challenging problem, but that challenging problem too is not their problem.
Yeah. That's why this is the good collaborations where we don't see the difficulty on that. Kita boleh solve kan dia. This is where the collaboration start in.
Yes.
Deliver first times, build the trust, then we carry on afterwards lah.
Correct.
Okay. Interesting. So we going back to Dr. Aznawan because last time you mentioned about IP and whatnot. So there's a popular words right now talking about co-creations, co-creating the IP with the problem statements and bringing up the solutions. Mm. So maybe Dr. Aznawan, maybe you can share a bit about the concept of this and what is the carry on the UM right now.
Okay. Jadi kalau kita lihat orang kata trend sekarang, the push factor untuk move towards research towards commercialization ni is orang kata it's a very top-down directive lah daripada kementerian sampai ke bawah kan. Sebab kita nampak lah macam geran-geran DPRN memang it's a matching grant, maksudnya industri dan juga universiti dan kementerian. Lepas tu ada geran-geran macam PRGS, even as fundamental as it goes, FRGS pun kena ada industrial collaborator, at least dapat LOI. So it's very what we call apparent lah that right now the government is moving towards even though you're doing research, it has to be validated by the industry partner, kan? So I mean benda ni quite logical, so that whenever an IP is generated, IP tu ada immediate take up partner, orang yang boleh buat market validation about the so called technology. Itulah strategi dia yang kata yang kita nak push untuk sekarang ni. Jadi daripada segi universiti pula, okay, we are totally embracing that, you know, at this point. Yang mana kalau kita tengok sebenarnya, kalau kat Malaysia ni, saya suka guna term ni lah. Sebenarnya kita sekarang ni berada dalam satu fasa yang dipanggil revolusi penyelidikan.
Revolusi penyelidikan, you know.
I mean, macam mana kita nak disrupt how research is being done at this particular country. Sebab kalau kita tengok macam Toyota kan, at one point they invest dalam satu kolaborasi, I can't remember, maybe boleh check lepas podcast ni, tapi dua big industry lah, I can't remember, I think was MIT and Stanford. Tapi dia bagi sejumlah dana beratus juta juga lah kepada apa dua company, dua industry. But the thing that I like bila I baca artikel tu, bukannya sebab dia bagi sekali, Okay, the collaboration
ada follow up.
Collaboration tu katalah 5 tahun. Habis 5 tahun tu, Toyota sangat berpuas hati dengan nilai penyelidikan tu. Dia bagi lagi. You know, itu yang kita nak.
Dia don't mind spending. Dia don't mind spending.
Itu yang kita nak. Maksudnya orang kata macam yang Dr. apa Amin cakap tadi tu, bila kita berbincang tentang penyelidikan, inovasi dan sebagainya, equity sebenar yang kita jarang bincangkan selain daripada teknologi yang dihasilkan, novelty dan sebagainya adalah trust. Okay, so for people to trust enough the technology that is being created by the university untuk digunakan dan dipasarkan. And dekat Malaysia ni sendiri, more than 90% is actually SME. Kalau kita teliti kelas-kelas SME itu, ada small, medium and large. Kalau PMKS, perusahaan mikro kecil dan sederhana tu boleh setakat 5 employee je, 5 staff, tapi they are still making money. Tapi bila kita nak bincang dengan satu kat PMKS, perusahaan mikro kecil sederhana yang tentang IP ni, they don't care about IP. Dia lebih kisah berkenaan dengan how
jimat,
what's the value that this technology is going to help them. Jadi dekat situ lah orang kata, this in order for Malaysia to move the needle to the next step. Sebab kita dalam revolution ni, is for us to be able to move the masses. Dan kalau kita tengok mass tu siapa? Mass tu actually SME. Macam mana university nak work with valid problem statement that is validated by the SMEs, okay, so that we are able to, you know, move to the next level lah. And then kita kena keluar daripada this dilemma yang mana semua pula kita cakap, saya ni pragmatik sikit. a bit controversial lah. So kita tak boleh lagi bergantung pada kerajaan. Kerajaan saya selalu cakap dengan rakan-rakan saya dekat universiti, ahli jabatan saya, FRGS tu satu Malaysia minta.
You? Professional berapa?
Satu Malaysia minta. Tapi just imagine if you are brave enough and then you know you have a certain network, you pergi kepada perusahaan A and bercakap, kata, apakah yang boleh saya tawarkan untuk membantu syarikat tuan? Kan? Dan untuk masa yang terdekat ni, saya tak kisah sangat berkenaan dengan orang kata dana yang diperlukan. Sebab apa yang kita boleh tawarkan? So university, when you talk about university, kita mungkin tak ada duit sebab kita orang kata satu apa ni kerajaan ni satu apa agensi kerajaan
non profit and good industry.
Tapi daripada segi apa kita punya strength is we have talents. That should be our equity, you know. So dekat Universiti Melayu, semasa saya di faculty lah, antara benda yang saya push adalah sebab di Faculty Science Computer, dia punya latihan industri tu is sandwich. Semester kelima, tahun 3 semester pertama, so they have to do another 2 semesters where for their FYP. Jadi masa kita melawat tu, kita tengok kalau ada potensi dan kita akan cakap lah, why not continue the collaboration dengan faculty, okay? And apa kita boleh panjangkan kolaborasi ni sebab internship dekat UM untuk FSKT berkaitan komputer adalah 24 minggu ataupun 6 bulan. So, kalau dia continue the same, I mean the industry continue with the collaboration for the FYP, that's like 1.5 years of engagement with the student lah.
Betul.
Jadi kami dah ada quite a few success story. Kita bekerja dengan Skyworld Development Berhad, satu syarikat property. And even saya ada spin-off company daripada UM, Felix and Berhad. So kita form a joint venture punya company yang mana saya ambil satu talent yang sangat hebat lah, Cik Omar ni. He's an influencer dekat Twitter dan dia sangat bagus daripada segi teknikal. Dan kita letak dia sebagai CTO of this newly form joint venture company ni, Himaya Technologies and Berhad. Satu kerjasama lah between Felix, syarikat spin-off UM dengan Wasiah Shop. Tapi just imagine this kid, anak muda ni, dia dah tak muda sangat lah kan sekarang. Dah dekat 30. Tapi dia tak pernah sehari pun bekerja dengan orang. Immediately, dia sebelum dia graduate, jasnya, dia dah graduate masa tu, dia kami jadikan dia CTO sebagai syarikat tu. Immediate gaji dia dah 5 figure. Itulah kualiti pelajar kita, talent kita, okay. So how I relate back dengan IP. So bila bila industri sedar akan kebolehan universiti, trust is established, then we will move from just pure contract research ataupun industry research grant from this concept of shared IP. So now we have more leverage. Kita kata walaupun you all bayar kita, okay, untuk apa in terms of industry research, tapi sebenarnya nilai yang you dapat banyak sangat. Mm-hmm. Sebenarnya you leverage on double tax deduction.
Yes.
Essentially the research is being done for zero cost tau. As long as dia punya profit that dia declare untuk tahun tu lebih daripada amount yang dia sumbangkan. Sebenarnya it's zero cost.
Betul.
Okay, cuma dia kena put some money up front lah. Okay. Lepas tu dia dapat bekerja dengan nama macam UTM, UM, the RUs and even universiti-universiti lain macam universiti teknikal kan. So lepas tu dia dapat akses kepada kita punya talent,
equipment,
infra dan sebagainya. So for us to move in this industrial revolution, I mean in this research revolution, sepatutnya ada itulah kata kerjasama yang menyeluruh, so that this concept of shared intellectual property between the industry and the university tu is realised. Macam mana kita nak move together kalau kita tak nak share?
Betul.
So yeah, I think itulah kata aspirasi yang dekat ini sebenarnya kita cuba push. You know, only if you become true partners, then you know kita boleh, kita ada harapan lah untuk move out of this middle class income punya nation yang trend.
Yes. So this is something that I recently knew lah. Selepas saya keluar dari universiti and having my present in Meranti, surprisingly I learned these new things lah regarding the IP lah. Dekat universiti we produce IPs as part of KPI dalam grant dan sebagainya. So this is what we call as background IP. Tapi bila background IP ni dibawa ke corporations within industries, kita boleh menghasilkan another IP which is foreground IP, which we share IP itulah. And this is where the solutioning is entire. So again, the trust is starting from day one, and then from there carry on until delivery and afterwards the benefits lah. Okay, right. So I guess this is the second round regarding the collaborations. So now we move to the third round, which is the last one, which is the future directions of and also the policy implications. So I guess I'm coming back to Dr. Aznul. Regarding on the future directions, especially you can pick up lah sebab your background in PI and sebagainya. Maybe you can share a bit about what's the future directions of commercialization, IP and whatnot. Maybe in particular on AI.
Okay, so bila kita berbincang pasal penggunaan teknologi, I had like sebab my company ni sebenarnya kita develop customized AI solution, but at the same time kita ada kita punya chatbot technology lah yang baru-baru ni pun kita dapat certification from MOSTI through MySDI. Kalau search on MySDI tu boleh lah jumpa chatbot teknologi yang dipanggil CRISPY lah.
Tanya MySDI
patent tu pun actually is being held through another SPV lah. So Felix ni dia macam mini TTO. So kita nampak benda tu okey, pop kita initiate another SPV. So right now kita ada two arms lah. Satu is working on focusing on fintech together dengan Wasiah Shop. So another one focusing on chatbot lah under Discovery. So Felix jadi pemegang saham. So these two are like associate companies. Tapi what I'm trying to say is bila saya pergi present dan berkenaan chatbot tu kepada satu agensi kerajaan, kita pun ceritalah pasal chatbot semua kan, pasal macam mana dia boleh menjawab soalan dan sebagainya. Lepas tu tiba-tiba one of the pegawai tu, officer tu tanya, minta maaf kata, dia kata kat mana AI nya? Okay, you know, because at least in this day and age, the term AI tu is often being associated dengan benda yang mengagumkan. Ada surprise factor, ya. So kalau kita kata Google dia punya background search engine tu AI, Spotify yang dia recommend lagu tu AI, orang kata mana AI? YouTube dia punya apa dia recommend the apa tiba-tiba kita dapat video yang hampir sama kan, dengan kita punya kan. Semua tu itu bukan AI, you know. So definisi AI at least for the masses today bukan yang kita ahli akademik faham, ya. Jadi bila kita AI ni sering orang kata associated dengan kontroversi lah, macam Terminator kan, it's going to take over, revolutionize our workplace dan sebagainya.
It's classic.
Itu yang orang push and associate with AI. Jadi dekat sini in terms of orang kata daripada segi IP, lepas tu tak cukup dengan protection of the technology tu, kita perlukan peranan-peranan macam yang dimainkan oleh Meranti, AI sandbox. So the thing about technology is, I mean, bila kita nak buat orang kata the goal of protecting a technology through IP, saya tak suka guna perkataan commercialization lah, saya suka guna perkataan value creation.
Okay.
Sebab value creation ni meluas sikit, you know, create impact. Tak semestinya kita buat duit saja. Kadang-kadang kita use the IP untuk bantu NGO dan sebagainya. Okay. Tapi we have to be able to use the IP in a safe manner yang kita hak universiti sebagai pemilik IP tak, orang kata, tertindas lah. Okay. Okay. Jadi untuk kita buat ni, normally kita akan cuba, sebab macam kita cakap tadi, AI ni dia cuba solve big problems yang kita nak cuba gunakan dalam lingkup ruang lingkup kesihatan. So kena ada kerjasama dengan KKM. Jadi peranan Meranti yang dimainkan tu sangat baik, sebab ada sandbox yang mana a safe space where we can actually deploy the technology dengan bantuan pemegang-pemegang taruh yang berkaitan, tanpa kita punya kisah apa yang mungkin terjadi. You know? Tapi as long as kita dapat input daripada KKM, okay, this can be done, this can be done, this can be done, this can be done. So dia speed up the adoption rate of AI tu, technology tu. Macam hari ni lah, you know, kalau saya ambil apa ni, kata contoh large language model kan, buat masa ni dekat Malaysia, yang betul-betul memainkan peranan untuk develop our own very own LLM adalah yang orang tahulah, Mesolitica, melalui dia punya apa, Malang punya LLM tu. Tapi yang ada yang lain daripada universiti dan sebagainya, tapi tak mainstream sangat. Tapi kalau tengok dekat Vietnam, they have like more than 5-6 LLMs for the Vietnamese language. Sebab kegunaan dia tu sangat besar. So itulah bagi saya, apa, bagi saya itulah, kalau macam kita nak limit dengan AI dan dengan IP tu, is our ability to be able to, peranan universiti ni lah, pada peranan pada pandangan saya pada hari ini, kita kena guna teknologi yang kita ada ni, AI, untuk solve satu masalah-masalah yang pragmatik, yang praktikal daripada industri. Tapi at the same time, we should be able to use it to solve problem-problem yang orang kata membelenggu masyarakat kita, macam apa, overcrowding dekat hospital. Overcrowding dekat hospital, you guna AI untuk predict sama ada patient tu patut masuk ataupun dia boleh dilepas.
Yes.
Benda-benda praktikal, tapi itulah kegunaan universiti, if we are able to contribute back. So benda tu patut di IP-kan, sebab mungkin ada valuation kat situ, dan ada win-win situation between hospital dan dekat universiti untuk sama-sama commercialize and whatever for that part of technology.
Okay, terima kasih Dr. Aznul. Okay, terima kasih Dr. Aznul for the input that you have provided to us in terms of the IP related to the, kata, the future direction, so and relate it back to the AI. Now we coming back to Dr. Amir. What is the future directions in your, kata, in university ataupun in your, what your the role that you are having right now, the directions of this collaborations, and you can pick up on your backgrounds, knowledge and also experience on learning tadi kan, so you can
start. So as a university, in terms of per area, we are mandated by the JPT for food security, keterjaminan makanan.
Okay.
Because our previous name pun was University Pertanian Malaysia, and many kata pakar-pakar pertanian yang ada di Malaysia ni pun probably came from apa ni, Institut Pertanian, which is apa ni, UPM lah dulu, ataupun Institut Pertanian ataupun currently
the legacy lah.
So it is our DNA yang pertanian tu. However, kita venture in many other technology as well. Many other areas as well. So, engineering, medical science and so on. Dekat UPM, kita cuma tak ada mengajar Islam dengan dentistry, if I'm not mistaken, dengan law. Okay. So all others memang kita ada. So in terms of current direction, it is clear it is towards the food security.
Okay.
So for example, very recently, Ministry of Economy collaborate with us for the IPR project.
Okay.
So IPR project ni kita akan kita sedang membangunkan pusat kecemerlangan industri pertanian.
Oh, okay.
Jadi the center tu would be a place where many agricultural industries can thrive in many ways lah. Maknanya can facilitate the current big players expedite their own product ke, or can kata apa, give birth to agripreneur, the next probably agricultural unicorn would probably come from this center of excellence maybe.
Okay.
And who knows. So dekat situ saya lihat lah the apa ni kepentingan on the collaboration ni, because we basically kalau kata we want to do big things, we have to have a team lah. And team has to have different function. Nah, kalau kata macam katanya kita okay, let's make a team. Kita tiga orang. Tapi tiga-tiga pun adalah researcher, dan tiga-tiga pun adalah researcher dalam area yang sama. Tiga-tiga have the same concern, we would not make a great team.
Betul.
So dia mesti ada apa ni, kalau macam company kan, dia ada apa, CEO dia, CTO dia.
Each of everyone play their roles lah.
Yeah, their own role. So you cannot play, kata apa, you cannot assemble orang yang memainkan peranan yang sama dan make a great team, cannot.
Macam meriwang lah, kalau kata royong semua nak kata dodol kan.
Semua nak kata dodol, tak boleh. So, CIA has its own theory on this team things ni. Okay. Dia kata a great team would have a four animal.
Okay.
One is lion, fox, bear, and also cheetah.
Semua ada elemen, animal ni.
Dia ada animal punya elemen. So cheetah is someone yang laju dalam make decision, and the doers. Maknanya you meeting, sometimes tak siapa nak buat. Okay, siapa nak, maknanya you cannot get things moving because there is no cheetah in the team.
Oh, okay.
So lion is someone yang organize the thing. Not necessarily the leader. But he or she can organize the things, can make the appointments, can very organized.
Yeah.
Okay, basically the organizer, so to speak.
Okay.
Fox is the analytical brain,
the cunning one.
The one that do the calculations, probably do the whatever the things yang details and so on. And bear is the one that take care of the. Kata apa, the teams the teams to get together because of the bear.
The group up lah.
The group, because of bear function tu.
I see.
Macam family kan. Yeah, macam family. So you get the ukhuwah of the team tu because there is the bear.
Oh,
so in any teams, since we successfully get the IPR collaboration for Ministry of Economy tu, I usually observe this thing. Do we have enough of this animal?
Okay.
In each of the team. If we have,
wow,
there are high chance of that team being successful.
Profiling eh?
Yeah.
Okay, interesting.
So katalah in the situation that we assemble, nak buat macam mana eh? We are four fox here.
Kacau orang.
But you have to decide now, one fox should play a lion function, one a bear function, one is cheetah function. So I think we can play that kind of adjustment lah. Because sometimes kalau kata researcher kan, we cannot. I mean, I'm a fox. She also a fox. Kan? So kita kena fikir, okay tak apa. Okay, this time I play a bear function.
Secondary lah.
Yeah. Yes. Maknanya kita tak payahlah macam orang kata apa. Memang nak that function juga. Okay. So the good thing is apa ni? If we can play member punya role ni, the team member punya role, it's very high chance for team success. Because kita sekarang ni sebenarnya menukar societal punya arus, which society usually heroize the leader. Macam tadi kata yang awal-awal kata kan, figura tu kan. You it's a norm in our society untuk heroize the leader, the CEO and whatever. We are not it's not norm for us to heroize a team.
Yes.
Tak ada. Oh, this is the team yang ni. No.
Tapi masalahnya amalan kita dekat Malaysia ni memang nak jadi hero.
Yes. That's why semua orang nak jadi hero.
Tapi tak jadi apa-apa.
Yes. So kita kena macam kena normalize kan, actually without the team ni we cannot be successful.
Agree, completely agree on that. So yeah, I guess there's a two different I guess say input from these two experts, and but I guess all of these inputs is really fascinating for the discussions. So we are coming to the last round of our tidbit sessions. So the last round typically sounds like, what's your advice based on your experience after few years having center of being in the industry to universities? What your advice for the future?
My advice is that number one, that kita tidak boleh menolak, mana tidak boleh tidak perlu ada this collaboration.
Betul.
Internally, externally, mesti kena ada. And dalam collaboration ni, we have to, it's not an overnight punya hubungan. And more importantly, it's not a transaction.
There's a statement mungkin tak elok ataupun tak sesuai kerja ni, one night standing eh.
One night standing, kita kontrak ni satu malam. And it's not also a transaction. Maknanya bukannya, okay, aku tolong kau sekali, kau tolong aku sekali.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, RM10,000 je. Okay, kalau RM10,000 je, kita macam ni je. No, it's not. It's to build trust. Macam kata macam kita dengan kawan kan. Dia tak ada, itu dia belanja. Itu, dia tak belanja lagi, so aku tak boleh belanja. No, if you nak belanja, you belanja lah kan. So, sama juga dengan sama isteri ke apa. So, the relationship is not a transaction.
Yep.
And then we have to cultivate it, then take risk. Take risk means we are prone to being ditipu ke ataupun we are prone to that. Because if you don't take risk, nothing great will very much.
Okay, there are some terms that I just learned few weeks back lah. The bigger failure is not try.
Yes.
So maksudnya kalau you tak try, it's a failure already.
Yeah.
So why not we try and fail and then we learn.
Yeah.
And then we try again. Kan?
Oh, I want to add.
Sure. Yeah. Okay. This is the thing that I love Dr. Amin, because there's a lot of philosophical that we can learn together.
Daripada kita tadika, sejak satu, sekolah rendah kan, so mendengar, sampai masuk universiti pun, we are not, we are punished when we fail.
Yes.
Yes. We are not encouraged to fail.
Yeah.
So
fail SPM, gelap masa depan kau. Yeah. This is the culture.
We are being punished. Maknanya people are afraid to fail. And this culture need to change.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because if you want a very good entrepreneurship and so on, you need to fail. I mean, everybody knows.
Yeah. Embrace the failure.
Yes. Embrace failure. And all the sandbox university ke apa ke is place to fail.
Yes.
I believe university pun, if we can have a place to fail many times, because only after we fail tu yang akan ada kejayaan.
Betul. Yeah. Pivoting and what not. Yeah. Okay, thank you Dr. Amin. So coming back to Dr. Azno, what your advice in the audience, for the audience to benefit?
Think banyak lah kalau kita advice. Tapi picking up daripada momentum yang Dr. Amin dan Dr. Al tadi, macam kita cakap tadi, dalam this revolution to shift from research towards validation or commercialization ni, the most important thing is just to try, untuk cuba, sebab bila kita cuba tu, at least kita ada peluang untuk berjaya. Lepas tu, sebab saya ni, we are AI people. So, the concept of ada satu dalam machine learning, dia panggil concept gradient descent. Gradient descent algorithm. So, the concept of convergence. So, kalau you start InsyaAllah, okay, you start dekat main titik mana-mana dan guna, kalau saya simplify the algorithm tu, menggunakan data dan sebagainya, there is a possibility untuk for you to converge and reach your destination. You might be stumbled into like orang kata sub-optimal punya result, which is local minimum lah. Local minimum ni maksudnya bukan global minimum yang apa, yang teluk yang sebenarnya yang nak capai. Tapi then you can actually think about cara nak keluar daripada local minimum tu. At least you learn something. So I think that's the ni lah, macam mana benda-benda yang kita sama-sama fikirkan. Sebab bila kita nak buat ni, dia memerlukan usaha satu negara lah kan, untuk kita keluar daripada dilema yang kita hadapi sekarang ni. Sebab kita semua nak sangat, berharapan sangat dengan, dan nak negara kita ni jadi negara kaya. Sebab saya baru ada satu kawan yang dia migrate ke Ireland. So dekat sana dia dapat gaji lebih kurang 11,000 euro
sebulan.
Ah, sebulan. Boleh beli Miami. Kan? You
know? Tapi 11,000 euro sebulan.
Kan? Tapi kerajaan dia sangat kaya in a sense yang 11,000 euro dia ambil 45% tax.
Yes.
So but, dia dapatlah 6,000 euro. Tapi 6,000 euro tu masih selesa untuk dia untuk hidup sebab cost of living dia manageable, ada susu semua. So kita ni sebagai rakyat Malaysia ni, kita berimpian lah kita boleh jadi sebuah negara yang orang kata prosperous macam tu. Jadi itu hanya itu hanya akan terjadi kalau institut pengajian tinggi kita sangat-sangat memainkan peranan dalam memajukan negara. Sebab banyak sangat dana yang keluar daripada poket kerajaan untuk research dan sebagainya. Tapi macam mana kita nak return back to the rakyat tu. So itulah saya berbunyi macam negarawan sikit. Tapi itulah semua kata semangat yang saya rasa saya nak sangatlah kalau semua. Lepas tu kan saya suka dengar satu apa quote daripada Jack Ma kan. Jack Ma, sebab saya rasa benda ni kalau semua orang ada that kind of philosophy, dia sangat sangat baiklah. Maksudnya dia, kita bekerja lah, kerja umur 30 tu chase your dream sebab you ada space untuk orang kata fail. But starting at the age of 40, focus on doing what you do best. Okay, jangan berubah sangat lah sebab tapi start daripada umur 50, you dah fikir macam mana you nak transition and bantu orang keliling.
That would be beautiful.
60, bukanlah. Dan ini dia punya falsafah dia lah. Sebab sekarang ni Jack Ma 60 this year. Sebab tu dia dah resign as CEO of Alibaba. Tapi start 60 dia dah resign, dia tinggal, dia focus on family. Saya bukanlah kata macam tu. Tapi untuk kita ni dalam bidang akademik ataupun bidang apa-apa, kena ada element of selflessness. Untuk bantu orang lain. Okay. So dalam tugas kita ni, kalau saya duk fikir company saya je tak maju, kan, saya dah cuba dah ni 10 tahun tak jadi kan. Maybe it's time for me menggunakan pengalaman saya untuk cerita dengan orang lain macam mana mereka patut buat untuk berjaya dalam apa orang kata perjalanan startup di universiti. Saya tak berjaya tapi mereka berjaya. And saya sendiri, I cakap dengan sangat jujur lillah ni. Okay. Saya tak kisah mana-mana universiti, UPM, UTM or whatever, UTEM. As long we have our own one so-called startup yang orang kata terlahir daripada universiti, kolaborasi universiti, industri yang kita boleh call sebagai a Malaysian product. That is my thing. At this age lah, saya rasa. Sebab penat lah, hari-hari terbangun, aksi aku. You know? It's time for us to think about other people. So that's my biggest dream lah. And I think it's a spirit and vision that is shared by the university. How to move together. You know? So, itulah.
So, Dr. Amir, do you think it's a bear, it's a lion, it's a what?
It's more like a lion, maybe, I guess.
Lion campur dengan bear.
Lion campur dengan bear, yeah.
Okay, right. So, that's your animal elements inside. So, okay, I guess we are the brink of the ending of our episode. So, thank you again to Dr. Aznol and also Dr. Amir for your precious time spending with us today in this session, in this episode. And we hope that we are going to have you guys again in any occasions, in any activities, because people out there who watch these videos, who watch these episodes, Merantis right now is embarking into a new program, which is working on the what we call as venture co-creations, where we try to engage the universities, then we got the industries with the problem statements, and from there we able to come up with the greatness of everything and bring back to the benefit of the society, to the rakyat. So yeah, we can talk more on that later on, but stay tuned with us at Meranti. Visit us on www.meranti.my, and also for the our current program running right now, which is the AI Sandbox. You can go to meranti.my/AI. And yeah, I guess we also have a few events this year, which is the MCY, Malaysian Commercialization Year, which is just around the corner in 12-30 in August. And also end of this year, we are going to have iNations, which will be inviting all these participation from abroad and whatnot. So definitely, we hope that you guys can come and you know, the university can come and look into how we to work together. So that being said, again, thank you for everyone. So let's meet up for another episode, inshallah. And from there, I would like to say that thank you and have a nice day.